All right, so Eric, what are we multiplying by? We first of all, this one here, we're rationalizing the denominator. So what are we doing?
So you times the root 5.
Are we multiplying 3 root 5 by anything, or is it top and bottom?
Well, top and bottom.
Okay. Both. We, of course, want to create a balance, don't we? So we're multiplying it by what?
3 square root 5 and 3 square root 5.
I don't think you have to multiply it by 3 root 5, just root 5. If you you can multiply by 3 root 5, but you're just creating more work for yourself. Mm. So square root of 5 on square root of 5. Okay, so what do I have on, as a numerator, Eric?
3 times 5, that's 15.
Okay, so I've got 2 root 15 on the top. And on the bottom, we have 3 root 5. Now, what's root 5 times root 5?
It's 5.
5, okay. Five so three. 5 times 3 is?
15.
15. Can we simplify that any further?
No, I don't think so.
That's all we can do. Sometimes when you have a square root on the top and the bottom, you can take out, you can split that up into two and do some cancelling. In this case, no, just leave it as is. Now, on the for the next one, Joel,
yeah.
What did you multiply, what did you do to that one to rationalise this
so
question?
Square root of 5 as well.
Well, if you multiply it by the square root of 5, I'm not sure if that's, think about it, if I had this, if I had A minus B times A plus B, if I was to expand that out, I'm going to get A times A is going to give me A squared, and A times B is going to give me AB, and subtract AB, and subtract B squared. These two terms are going to cancel out. The only way we're going to rationalise the denominator is if we have two terms or we use the difference of perfect squares. So, I'm going to give you a hint. We've got to multiply numerator and denominator by 3 root 2. Is it plus root 5 or minus root 5. Okay, so that's what we've got to multiply by. You can try other things, but it's not going to cancel. These terms aren't going to cancel out unless we have 3 root 2 minus 5. So, let's do that. So we've got 3 root 2 minus 5 times by itself, as it turns out. Minus root 5, like so, and we have 3 times 3, do it separately, do the constants. 3 times 3 is 9, root 2 times root 2 is 2, 9 times 2 is 18. So that expression is going to give me 18. Then I have minus 3 root 10, which is this guy over here. Minus 3 root 10. And I then have another minus 3 root 10. And be careful with your signs. Negative times a negative is a positive. Root 5 times root 5 is 5, so that's positive 5. Now we know if we don't get a rational number on the bottom, then we haven't performed the calculations right. We know if we multiply those together, we're going to get a rational answer. Hence the word rationalizing denominator. So 3 root 2 times 3 root 2, once again, is 18. But this time we are subtracting 3 root 10. And this time over here, we're adding 3 root 10. They are cancelling each other out, so it's rational. And we have negative 5. So they cancel out. What's my answer? My answer is 23 minus 6 root 10, collecting those two like terms. These two guys here, and that is over 18 minus 5 is 13, and that's your answer. Can I get a show of hands of students who got that? Okay. Few of you, maybe anyone sort of keen to share what they did? Did they multiply it by something else? No. No, yes.
Not for me, I got that one right, but with A,
yep.
Could you times, instead of the square root of 5, could you times by 3 square root of 5?
You can, as long as you do the same to both top and bottom. It just makes your life a bit more difficult. Yeah, but yes, you can. All right, now let's have a look and see what we know about the index laws. Now, I've got the index laws on the board there, and I know that you've been through them in Year 9, but it's a while away. I know that you probably looked at them very early in the year, actually. First of all, I'm just going to pause the video here and... Actually, no, you know what? We'll go through them right now. Let's see what we know. First of all, we're looking at law what for dealing with this? Law three. Whereas if I've got anything in the brackets to the power of, I'm multiplying the power. Let's think about it more logically. What happens if I had 2 cubed to the power of 3? Now, a lot of you, some of you might just add those powers, but what is 2 cubed? 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2. And that to the power of 3 is that multiplied by itself 3 times. So, if you were to sort of draw it out like this, it might sort of seem logical that that would be 2 to the power of 9. Okay? What?
Oh, sorry, that one.
Okay, so that would be 2 to the power of 9. Now, the first thing we're looking at, law 3. So we're multiplying the powers. So let's do one step at a time. That's A to the power of 3 times... That is A to the power of 12 times A to the power of 5. And what do I do to the powers when I've got two index laws in the same base? I add them. Very good. Now, whenever you have constants, always deal with those constants. 2 times 7 is 14. I would do that first. 14. And what am I doing to those powers? We have two powers of the same base. I'm adding the powers. 3 minus 6 is minus 3. And you might have recalled last year, how could I write A to the power of minus 3? So in other words, that a to the power of minus 3 is the same as 1 over a to the power of 3. Why? I guess, well, anything to the power of 0 is 1. I could show you that. Let's just change that as a to the power of 0. Okay, because you might recall from last year, anything to the power of 0 is 1. Let's show you. A to the power of 0, I'm just going to replace that 1, and A to the power of 3. What's that going to give me? A to the power, what am I doing? What law am I using to simplify this? No, which law? Oops. Which? No, what am I doing if I have this one here? A to the power of 0 divided by? I'm using law 2, aren't I? What am I doing to the powers? I'm subtracting the one on the bottom from the top. 0 minus 3. So therefore, a to the power of minus 3. So 1 over a to the power of 3 is equivalent to a to the power of minus 3. I can just do that by changing 1 to a to the power of 0. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. Yes, it was 0. You can see there this question says, simplify each of the following. Express your answers with positive indices only.
So it can be 14 over A cubed.
Yes. So the answer is 14 over A cubed because that is a positive index, isn't it? Okay. All right, let's have a look at C. And we'll probably stop there because we haven't looked at fractional indices yet. We didn't look at that last year, and we haven't looked at it yet. And that's something that I would like to teach you to the side. Yes?
B comes up in question. If we answer with 14 A to the power of negative 3, is that technically wrong?
No, it's not wrong, but you wouldn't get 4 marks because it hasn't been simplified. Second one, let's have a look. Now, you could do this one of two ways. I wouldn't go doing each fraction in itself. What I would do, because then I'm probably going to have to deal with negative indices more often. I'm going to multiply across like so. So I'm going to apply law one for the top, for the top. So a squared times a is a to the power of 3. B cubed times b to the power of 5. We're adding the powers. B to the power of 8 over a to the power of 7. B to the power of 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay, now what do I want to do? I want to use law 2. And I'm subtracting 7 from 3. So I've got a to the power of 3 minus 7, which is a to the power of minus 4. B to the power of 8 minus 2 is 6. But of course, we've got to express with positive indices, don't we? So what we're going to do is we're then going to say, well, a to the power of minus 4 is equal to what? 1 over a to the power of minus 4. Power of 4. So my answer, simplified with a positive indice, is this. Voila, we can stop there. Now, you know what? We haven't looked at fractional indices yet, but the same thing applies. It's just that they're fractions. So you know what? Let's try this one. I'm going to pause this for a second, and I'd like you, based on the laws that we already know, let's have a go at question D, please. Here we go. So first of all, I'm going to just leave it like so. And, of course, it's divided by, but since it's not a fraction, I wouldn't go changing it to a times and flipping. That's all this is doing. Okay, so that's really all we're working with. It looks a little bit better now. Now, I'm applying law 3, or I guess law 4, where everything in the brackets we multiply the powers. So what we're left with is 5 to the power of negative 4 times a to the quarter times negative 4 is a to the power of negative 1. Like so. On the bottom, we have a to the power of 1 times negative 2/3 is a to the power of negative 2/3. B to the power of negative 2/3. All right, now, yes, you had a question, Isabella?
Actually,
nothing. Okay. All right, now what we can do is we can apply law 2. And law 2 states that a to the power of m over a to the power of n is a to the power of m subtract n. Now, of course, I've only got one indice there that I can simplify using that law. Oh, I keep losing my pen every time. Oh, there we go, it's back. So what we've got is I'm going to leave it as 5 to the power of minus 4, b to the power of minus 2/3, and I'm simplifying a to the power of minus 1. Let's write that out. A to the power of minus 1. Be careful with the signs here. We're subtracting negative 2/3. So I would probably do it this way. We're subtracting negative 2/3 because what happens? We're now, those two negatives there become a positive, don't they? So over here, that is the same as minus 1, positive 2/3. Positive 2/3. And what is minus 1, positive 2/3? Minus a third. Okay, so this is what we've got. We've got 5 to the power of minus 4. A to the power of minus 1/3. B to the power of minus 2/3. Okay, but we want positive indices. So what might we do? We can obviously flip this 5 to the power of negative 4, which we discussed before was 6, 1 over, or that's 1 over 625. Or 625 on the bottom. So that is 5 to the power of 4 on the bottom, which is 625. B to the power of 2/3 on the top. And A to the power of 1/3 on the bottom. Can we simplify it any further?
No.
Looks a bit ugly though, doesn't it? Looks pretty ugly. Or fugly. All right. Yes. One, away we go. First thing we're doing with this one is I want to change this divide to a times. Now, when doing that, be careful. A number of students, when using this negative index law, when I change from a divide to a times, don't worry about negative and positive. Just do the old flipperoo.
So you haven't started.
Okay. Well, I actually have, but I haven't. There you go. I paused the projector. Okay. So what we're going to do is we flip those around. So what we've got is on the top, we have this. Don't go doing anything yet. And like so. Now on the left-hand side, I'm going to do the what's in the brackets. 5 to the power of 2 is 5 squared, which is 25. A to the power of, I'm multiplying the powers, so that's A to the power of 8. B to the power of minus 3 times 2 is minus 6. And on the bottom, I have A to the power of minus 2B. All right, let's get rid of the brackets though. But also, what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply the two numerators. So, and we're going to apply law 1 for that. So 25 goes out the front, that just stays as it is. I won't do anything with that yet. A to the power of 8 plus 1, which is 9. B to the power of adding the powers. Remember though, some students do this. They go minus 6 plus minus 4 must be a positive. No, that's when you're multiplying two negative numbers. All right, think about the number line. If I'm at negative 6 and I'm subtracting 4, then we are subtracting 4 from negative 6. It is still a negative number, negative 10. So that is B to the power of minus 10. Okay. Now, on the left-hand side, we've got A to the power of minus 2. Double oops. Okay, let's do that. Let's just leave that. And effectively what I've got is I just want to deal with the left-hand side. Be careful though, that 5 is not cubed. That is outside the bracket. We are now saying that that is A to the power of negative 1 to the power of negative 3 is positive 3. B to the power of negative 3. Okay, now I'm going to apply law 1 with these guys here. So what's that leaves me with 25 A to the power of 9, B to the power of minus 10 over 5. Adding those powers of A is going to give me A to the power of 1, which we'll just write that for the time being. B to the power of 1 minus 3 is minus 2. Now we can apply law 2. And we are subtracting 1 from 9. We're also going to simplify that fraction. 25 over 5 is 5, isn't it? Okay, and that is A to the power of 8. B to the power of, I'm not going to just write my answer, it's minus 10 minus minus 2, which is minus 10 plus 2, which is minus 8. But we don't write it like so, do we? We write with positive indices, so therefore the answer is 5a to the power of 8 over b to the power of 8. Yeah, I think you made a mistake there, Yusra. So, I'm going to stop there. That's my...